Protecting private and confidential information has always been a high-stakes game of winners and losers. And as frequent headlines prove, no one and no company is safe. If you've got valuable information, someone is trying to get it now. Like most companies, you're probably doing everything you can with the time, energy, and resources you have, protecting what's valuable. But the appetite and financial reward for seizing that same information is so great, it may seem like a losing battle. And often it is. You can't keep sophisticated hackers out of your networks. In a survey conducted at the 2016 Black Hat Conference, 72% of the very security professionals whose sole job it is to protect networks expect that they will be hacked or breached within the year. The reason for this is there are so many different attack vectors or ways to get into your electronic devices, but no real defense. And these attack methods can be used against any of the different layers of your phone or computer. For example, apps that are intentionally programmed for malicious intent can capture tremendous amounts of data about you, your life, and your business. And even if they are not malicious, overreaching apps gather similar data, which you allow simply by accepting the terms of use. But let's say all your apps are good and you think you've locked down the app environment. It still makes no difference if the operating system has been compromised. And if the apps are good and the OS is good, the firmware can be attacked, compromising everything running above it. Finally, even in the fantasy world where every software layer of a device is secure, there are well-documented cases of the actual chips themselves being shipped with malware, as well as examples of attackers intercepting devices in shipment to replace the circuit boards and chips themselves. When this happens, you're owned from the moment you get your device. And while there are many forms of software attacks, there is one that stands out: zero-day attacks, for which, by definition, there is no defense. These are attacks for which the time between the discovery of the attack and its use is literally 0 days. Your information is siphoned off until someone discovers the breach, and at that point, a patch must still be developed and applied. When it comes to hardware, there is nothing more nefarious than firmware exploits. This is when changes are made to the software controlling the fixed components of your digital device, and even wiping the hard drive and reinstalling the operating system won't fix it. And since the technology supply chain has been known to be compromised, boards and chips can be replaced with chips installed with malware, again, giving intruders complete access to your new phone. And then there are people. Social engineering and human compromise have worked forever in the world of espionage, and it also works in leveraging or tricking people to gain access to electronic assets and control of their electronic devices. Intel Security did a survey of over 22,000 people, which revealed that 97% couldn't correctly identify a well-crafted phishing email, the Trojan horse approach to getting malware onto your digital device through an email that looks remarkably legit. Finally, there's been an explosion in attack surfaces, the places of entry to get your information. 10 years ago, there were no smartphones. Now, there are over 2 billion, each of which is a potential avenue for attack. 3/4 of organizations surveyed said they had experienced a data breach via mobile. 3/4. And in many cases, all that was needed to take full control of a person's phone was knowing their phone number and sending them a text message. Then everything on the phone is compromised. Contacts, calendars, photos, even access to the highly sensitive microphones, the high-definition cameras, and the location tracking RF signals. Everything. In a recent 60 Minutes investigation, hackers were able to break into a US congressman's smartphone, armed only with a number, and tracked his every move. And there are entire companies focused purely on developing mobile exploits. Reuters recently reported that one such company was sold for a valuation close to $1 billion, a clear sign that breaking into phones and seizing data is a highly profitable and focused business. Interestingly, some of the most data-hungry organizations are big corporations. They use the information for profiling and marketing purposes, and they count on companies like Facebook and Google to pinpoint their customers through their apps and platforms. This is big dollar business. these free services have a combined market cap approaching $800 billion. Chances are pretty good that appetite for data will not end soon. And while this clearly impacts consumers, what if sensitive corporate data is caught up in the vacuum as well? So, the attacks are happening all the time, and you can't keep people out. But you might be asking, what's really at risk? To find out, view part two of this story. And to learn more about the topics covered in this video, visit privoro.com/whatsatrisk.